Thulani, Gumede again. Welcome to my channel. Today I want to tackle one question that I feel is a very common question, especially from our upcoming authors. And the question is, how long should a book be? You know, ngiyangibona impela ukuthi ongazothi umbuzo lena oshiya abantu abaningi be worried ukuthi, you know, when should I stop writing, you know? I think it's a fair question. And I always try to answer that question every time ngibuzakala yona. Hence, I decided, let me do this video so that maybe I could have that one video that I'll always refer people to, you know. And before mhlambe ngichaze kabanzi to answer that question, I think one of the quotes that stood out for me way too early, which I am yokubhala, it's a quote by C.S. Lewis. C.S. Lewis, one of the greatest authors, you know, when we talk about guys who write books and at a different level, definitely you'll have C.S. Lewis good list. I'll put him in my top five of best authors you know I've ever read. And there's a quote by C.S. Lewis. He kuluma about the joy of words. You know, the quote reads, "To say the very thing you really mean, nothing less, nothing more, other than what you really mean." You know, that's the joy and the art of words. Meaning, if you've managed to say what you really wanted to say, nothing more or nothing less, that's the beauty of words, you know. And that is what I always try and explain to our fellow authors or upcoming authors when they find themselves worried about the size or the length of the book, you know. Uguti, my feel of it, Uguti, you know, it's all about trying to say what you need to say, nothing more, nothing less. Here with me, I've got a book that I got as a gift. Beautiful book, Don't Sweat the Small Stuff, by Richard Carlson. It's a very beautiful book, you know. One of those books that are, you know, you read them, you get glued. But look at the size of this book, you know. And then the second book that I've got, this is a book written by me, Love Rage, you know. One of those books that I keep going back to read, you know. It's, you know, we hardly go back to read our own works. I published this book last year in 2019, you know. One thing that I like about this book, other than the message itself, you know, look at the size, and then look at the size of this book, you know. Love Rage by Thulani Gumede. One thing about this book, every time I go back to read this book, I don't feel like adding anything on it. I feel like I've said what I wanted to say, you know. I don't feel like there's something I didn't share. I also don't feel like I overshared. It's just so perfect, Gimina. I feel like I've shared what I needed to share. I'm just going to make another example, you know. Have you, you know, some of us who go to church, you know, you'll visit other churches. I'm not making fun of them. I'm just using it as an example. You'll go to these other churches where mhlawumbe kuzocelakala ukuthi sicela ubaba uGumede azosha message mhlawumbe for women's ministry, you know. Uthola ukuthi message mhlawumbe ebidinga less than a minute to share, but ubaba uGumede umefika lapha epodium avesana afika aqala iculo, you know. Aqala iculo ubaba uGumede athathe mhlawumbe 5 minutes ecula, you know, efuna ukufaka ibandla kwi spirit manje ukuthi yabo. Afika faka abantu laphana kuculweke manje 5 minutes. Uma eqeda kulo 5 minutes ebese yashumayela, you know. Mhlawumbe another 15 minutes useshera izwi manje mhlawumbe besenhlizweni yakhe, you know. Ashere. Then after that ebese zosho lento abebizwele yona ebese sihlala phansi. Roughly you'll find ukuthi maybe u 20 minutes uzophela, you know. But uma usuhlala phansi ebese uyazibuza ukuthi mhlawumbe ngikushilo ebengifanele ngikusho, you know, ngikwazile ukukusho ngesikhathi noma ngiyithole sengi-overshare, you know. Another thing, mhlawumbe abantu who have preached before will attest to this, ukuthi the biggest challenge that a lot of preachers go through It's when, after the sermon, they look back at what they had intended to say, and then they find themselves with you. I wanted to say this and that and that, but somehow I found myself saying other things, you know, other than what I intended to do, you know. And you know, mhlampe kuma sermons, that thing ayibukeki ingazuthi ibe inkinga enkulu. But I've also read books that when you read them, people are trying to write thick books, you know. And in the process of trying to write those thick books, and then you find ukuthi they are going around in circles, you know. They are missing the plot now because they're trying to have words that they will just throw in to fill the book so that ibankulu, you know. There are many reasons why incwadi zibankulu. Some, they are big because of ama pages that have been used, and the layer of the book and all that, the fonts, and you know. People will have different approaches. But it comes back to that. Are you able to say what you wanted to say? Nothing more, nothing less. Anyone whom, in fact, a lot of people that are found to be eloquent speakers, they manage to say what needed to be said or what needs to be said, you know. They don't waffle with words, you know, and just spend time saying things that don't make sense so that they'll cover that hour that they are given, you know. Some messages take 30 minutes to share, you know. Are you able to feel, I've shared what I needed to share, and now it's about time, Uguti, let me just stop and go shala pants, you know. So, how long should the book be? This is my opinion, because I've also read around that. You'll find Uguta Banyabati, on average, a book, maybe we should have 50,000 words. Most of my books on average, but they are ranging around 20,000 words, you know. The current book that I'm working on, which is my seventh book, it's currently sitting at 24,000 words. And I'm still editing it, you know. And talking about editing in the same context, when you edit a book, when I edit my own work after writing like first draft, second draft, you read a chapter where you feel like, this chapter, I think I can replace or sum this chapter up into two paragraphs and slot it in another chapter, you know. You know, you also read a chapter where you feel like, the end here is so abrupt that I'll leave my readers confused or yearning for more, you know. And you don't want to do that when, you know, you are not able to sort of give them more in the following chapter. So you find yourself saying, hey, I think I can still add more. I can still add 50% in this chapter. The aim of the book is to make it so captivating that you don't lose your readers. When you write a book in a low size, Lona, it's not about just how many words you've put in. It's about the caliber of words you've decided to choose, you know. Are you able to grab your readers, you know? People who are able to do that, they can write even, you know, a thicker book, Gunale, and you are still glued because of how they've written their story, you know. But you find us as well, who write books, as Buga Zincane. But when you read that book, you realize, Gutai, this guy was so perfect with his words, you know. Even though the book, but he said everything that I felt I needed to hear from this book. And even when the book ends, I feel content with, wow, this guy said what he needed to say. So, Bangan Man, I feel I've answered some of you guys, you know. The size matter? Does the size matter? I don't know. They say size does not matter. No, I don't know. But I think it's all about the words, you know. Are you able to grab your reader, you know? When you reach the end of your book, are you able to, you know, reconcile with the reader and not leave them thinking, oh, I feel like the guy should have said more. It's good when you do that intentionally because you know you're coming up with a second series or it's a sequel, I mean. You know, it's good for you when you do that. But some people have done it with one book, thinking they've covered everything, only to find a good tea. Maybe you've promised people so much in the book, or maybe you've overloaded people with words, you know. And then, thank you so much for watching the Yeyeye Show with Thulani Gumede. So I hope I've answered your question. So please like the page. And also don't forget to subscribe. There's more topics that I think I'll be covering. Not that I think, I'll definitely be covering to really, really try and impact and teach. Thank you so much.